वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज शफीक अहमद एंड यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल, लेट्स लर्न टुगेदर।
A very good morning to all of you, my dear students. Welcome back to the class once again. Now we are going to discuss the chapter, the Delhi Sultans or the Sultans of Delhi. So next topic is in that chapter is power of the nobles, powers of the nobles. Nobles, logon ka haath mein kitni power tha? And who are the nobles? These are the people who used to stay in the court of the king, and they used to suggest, give suggestions to the king, advice to the king also. They are the ministers, like we are having nowadays, we are having ministers. So the nobles were like the ministers at that time. So we are going to discuss about the powers of those nobles. Let us see. The nobles were of Turkish or Afghan origin. So mostly they belong from Turkey or they belong from Afghanistan, because the people of Turkey or the Afghanistan, they are quite strong. They are masculine. Their muscles, they are having muscles, and they are really great in height also. So that's why they used to be selected. Most of them were the nobles of the king. In those days, powerful nobles held important positions of governors and commanders. You know? They were holding the positions of governors or the commanders. Commanders rehte the wo log bankar ya to governors bane hue rehte the. So these are the people who used to hold these positions of governors and the commanders. The chief nobles headed various departments also. So they used to have become the head of the various departments, such as the forest department, agriculture department, health department. Like we are having different type of ministers and in different format in our country also. So the wazir was also known as the prime minister. The prime minister was also known as the wazir, you can say. So he kept a record of revenue and expenditure. So that prime minister, or you can say the wazir, which you can say that they used to be right hand of the king also. So they used to maintain, this prime minister used to maintain the record of what? Revenue, that is income and expenditure. Means what are the income of the country or that particular place, or what are the expenditures. So wazir was used to record and maintain of this revenue and expenditure. The qazi, and there is a qazi also in the court. The qazi was the king's advisor on the religious matters. He used to advise the king on the religious issues, or what to be done next in the religious matters. If there is a question, if there is a query, or if there is any something questions regarding the religious matters, so qazi used to advise the king in such matters. The Arizi-e-Memalik was the overall in charge of the army. Now, who is the in charge of the army? He was known as the Arizi-e-Memalik. So they all are from the Turkish or the Afghan origin. In charge of the army, overall in charge of the army was known as Arizi-e-Memalik. And you can see under Alauddin Khalji, the state brought the collection as well as the assessment of law and revenue under its control. Under Alauddin Khalji, means he was not giving this control of collecting the taxes from the people. He was just controlling this from his hand. He just appointed his persons, his people, to look after all this. Before Alauddin Khalji and during other sultans, what they were doing, they were appointing the people of that particular region only to have to collect the taxes, to keep the records. But Alauddin Khalji has changed all these things. He appointed his people, his person from his court, to look after the affair, to look after the affairs, and to look after the assessment of the land revenue. Land revenue means income which was taxed from where the land, from the land which is coming. So the taxes of the land or the income from the land which was coming to the king treasure, it was under the control of Alauddin Khalji. So he changed all these things. He has not appointed the people of that only region. He appointed his people, Alauddin Khalji. So that was a change in the administrative level. Even you can see over here, the right of the local chiefs to levy taxes were cancelled under or during Alauddin Khalji. So the local chiefs, the people who were locally living at that particular place, at certain places, actually they were allowed to collect the taxes from the landholders. But Alauddin Khalji changed this thing and he just appointed his persons. They were forced, even they, those local chiefs were forced to pay taxes during the time of Alauddin Khalji. So those who are collecting tax, now they were paying tax in the time of, under the time of Alauddin Khalji. So that was the change. That was a great change under Alauddin Khalji. The persons who were collecting tax or from the other people, now they were forced to pay taxes, and collecting taxes were cancelled. They were not allowed to collect the taxes. Only the Sultan people or the Sultan administrators measured the land and they used to keep the accounts. So the people who were really close to Sultan, these Turkish and the people from the Turkey or people from the Afghanistan, they used to collect all the taxes and keep the records of the income and expenditure of the king. So that was a great change during that Alauddin Khalji time. I think someone raised hand. No, it is not so. Let us move ahead. Powerful chieftains. Now, who are the chieftains? Chieftains, you can see the local people who are having dominance or having some power. The local people. You can say in Hindi that boss type of people. You know, those who used to live in that particular local area and have some power. So they are the powerful chieftains. You know, jo chief log hote hain, wo kafi powerful hote hain. So Ibn Battuta, a 14th century traveler from Morocco, Africa, he explained those about those chieftains. He has written something about those chieftains. Chieftains kaun hai? Local people who used to have power. So chieftains, sometime they fortified themselves in mountains to save themselves. These chieftains, they used to cover themselves. They used to hide themselves. Or you can say it is written that they used to fortify themselves in the mountains. Yani mountains mein apne aap ko wo log kya karte the? Chupa lete the. In rocky, uneven and rugged places, as well as in bamboo graves. They used to hide themselves in the bamboo graves also, in the uneven places and even in the rugged places, which is not suitable for living. They used to live in those places. They used to live in such places to hide themselves from the king. Because these chieftains, this boss type of people, they used to go against the king. That's why they used to keep themselves hidden in these mountainous areas and even in the bamboo graves. Let me show you that with the help of image. Bamboo groves. Here you can see. Bamboo groves are quite dense, and it is really will be very difficult to find a person if a person is hiding in these bamboo groves. You will not be able to find that person after the sunset. It will be really impossible. And even during the sunrise also, in the morning also, you can't find such persons if they are hiding in these bamboo groves. So those chieftains used to hide themselves in these bamboo groves also. They used to hide themselves. The chieftains live in this forest, which serve them as ramparts, or you can say walls, inside which are their cattle and their crops. So the chieftains were living in these forests, in these bamboo groves, among these bamboo groves, and they were having their own cattle and their own crops. They were growing their crops also. They were having their cattle also, and these bamboo groves were working for them as wall. Diwar ki tarah ye bamboo groves hai, un logon ko bachate the. Even those mountains were helping themselves to save themselves from the king. So that was the thing. These mountains, the uneven, the rock places, the bamboo groves were helping the people, those chieftains, to save themselves from the attack of the king. And under these, they were having their own life. They were having their cattle, they were growing their crops. So they don't need anything from outside. They were just inside. They were living in inside. There is also water for them within. Pani ka bhi intizam unke andar hi hai, unke paas hai. They used to store water. They used to store the rain water which collects there. Whenever there is a rain in the forest, Wherever there is a rain in the mountain areas, mountainous areas, they used to collect water by digging canals or tanks, and by having tanks or the canals, they used to store the rainwater, and they used to use those rainwater for all the purposes. Even for drinking, they can just filter them, they can boil the water, and they were just drinking. So they don't need anything from outside. They were living inside, and they cannot be, and hence it is quite difficult to control them or even attack them, because they used to hide themselves, and they used to attack the attackers and kill them, because they used to hide themselves among these bamboo groves. So only powerful armies, those powerful armies can control such type of chieftains. Powerful armies means large number of armies, soldiers having great weapons with them. Only they can attack or they can win against them. So what those powerful armies, they used to attack, how they used to attack, those powerful armies of the king, they used to enter this forest, cut down the bamboos. And what they used to do, when they move ahead, they used to cut down all the bamboos. So after cutting, and then they used to move. So cutting the bamboos, and they were moving like this. So these powerful armies used to cut the bamboo trees, and then they used to move forward, with specially prepared instrument. They used to prepare some type of instrument or devices which is helpful to cut the bamboos. So they used to enter the forest, and they used to cut the bamboos. Then they used to reach that particular powerful chieftains, and then they used to control them, they used to attack them. So less powerful armies cannot control them. So that is the thing, my dear students. Okay, let us move to the next topic, my dear students. Stages of manuscript. Manuscripts are those things which are written by hand, jo haath se likhe hue hote hain. They are known as manuscripts. Manuscripts which are printed on paper, they are known as printed materials. But how the people were creating these manuscripts in earlier period, है ना, लोग जो है ये manuscript पहले कैसे बनाते थे? And let me give you the definition. A book, document, or a piece of music written by hand, है ना, या एक किताब लिखा हो, या एक document लिखा हो, और या lyrics, है ना, lyrics of a particular music is written by hand is known as manuscripts. So how the people were doing this manuscript, you can see that is the first step, the step number A, or first step, preparing the paper. First of all, the people of that time, they used to prepare a paper like this. And dekho wo paper ek taiyar kar raha hai. One of the person is preparing a paper, you can see over here in the image. And what is the next step, let me show you. After preparing the paper, they used to write the text. वो क्या करते थे उसके बाद उसमें text लिखते थे. यानी one of the person is writing text on that. You can see over here. So prepare paper को prepare करने के बाद उसपे text लिखा जाता था. And then you can say the third step क्या है? Melting gold to highlight important words and passages. So one of the person is melting gold. Gold को melt करके पिघला कर वो लोग क्या करते थे, किसी भी words को या passages को क्या करते, highlight करते हैं. Nowadays we are having a highlighter, है ना, अभी हम लोगों के पास क्या होता है, एक pen type का material होता है, highlighter जिसको बोलते हैं, और we used to highlight the important words and sentences. But in those days they were not having pen, they were not having such type of highlighter. So what they were doing, what they were using, they were melting gold and other materials of different color, so they can use it to highlight the important words and passages. So you can see it was quite expensive. Those manuscripts may be quite expensive. And we can say that in the fourth step, one of the person is preparing the binding, है ना, एक आदमी जो है किताब को binding कर रहा है. So these were the stages of making a manuscripts in those days, है ना, step A, B, C, and D. This was that. Oh, that the steps of making a manuscripts successfully that I showed you. So if
hope that you have liked the video. And we will meet again in our next video release of the tutorial. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon. to get the information of the next release of the tutorial. Please share it with your friends and others also. Thank you for the time being. Take care. Stay at home. Bye-bye. Take care.